In Commitment 2010, we are less than a week away from Election Day. Let's focus again on the very tight race for Ohio's congressional district.
Yes, earlier tonight we took you behind the scenes of Republican Steve Chabot's campaign. This is in the 1st District. Now News 5's Amy Wagner does the same with the incumbent Democrat, Steve Driehaus.
Well, the very heated Driehaus-Chabot race has gotten a lot of attention, but tonight we have a rare behind-the-scenes look at that race. We take you inside Steve Driehaus' campaign.
I'm Steve Driehaus. I'm the congressman from the 1st Congressional District.
This is the Steve Driehaus in the public eye, but behind this man is an army of others.
Hang on a second. Alex?
Including this man, Tim Mulvey, the Cincinnati native who is Driehaus communications guru on Capitol Hill and on his campaign.
A campaign is much, much more than just the candidate.
I know.
Even though we disagreed, I thought we found some common ground.
I think we do.
In the final days before the election, Driehaus goes nonstop on this day, starting at a breakfast in Woodlawn.
Hey, how you doing?
I want to come over and say hi to the power brokers.
Hey, Driehaus, how are you, sir?
Then rushing to meet others at a prayer event on Fountain Square.
Wondered if you would have any time to canvass between now and November 3rd.
All the while, behind the scenes at 5 campaign offices across his district, his campaign is in crunch mode. Volunteers are working the phones.
We are looking for people to help us on Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. We have all different kinds of times.
Driehaus Camp is relying on a massive get-out-the-vote effort this weekend. A September poll shows Driehaus down 12 points to his opponent, Steve Chabot, who Driehaus himself unseated in 2008. Driehaus calls that poll
bogus,
claiming the only poll he's relying on is next Tuesday.
I didn't lead in the polls last time. I haven't led in the polls this time.
Polls aside, his camp is focusing on one thing.
A shift in momentum in this district.
The focus for Driehaus' campaign, not undecided voters, but unlikely voters.
The way we win is on the ground. And so we have a tremendous ground game. You know, we've got 8,000 cups, we've got lit, we've got stuff that does me no good on November 3rd.
A game that could have changed considerably when the National Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee recently pulled $500,000 in funding. But Driehaus' camp insists.
That hasn't really changed our game plan at all. We have seen people across Greater Cincinnati become more energized and more enthusiastic after the DCCC changed their funding structure for our campaign.
So Driehaus, his staff, and hundreds of volunteers put everything they have into their Get Out the Vote effort, confident that in this race, there's no front runner.
This race is neck and neck. This district is neck and neck.
And the Chabot-Driehaus campaigns have each raised about the same $1.7 million. Cheryl, Jack?